Hi, I'd like to show you guys a little something about the meaning of the word illusion. We've sort of been talking about the difference between illusions and truth, and tonight I'd like to demonstrate that for you with some rope. There's a piece of rope right there. This is standard issue hardware store rope. And I've got some that's very long and some that's very short and some that's sort of in between. And I'm going to create an illusion for you using these three pieces of rope. Now you can tell they're different lengths because they start all at the same place and they end at three different places. That's a clue. So in order to create the illusion that they're the same length, we need to make them end at the same place. So there's rope number one and rope number two and rope number three. And now they start at the same place and they end at the same place. They don't quite look like they're the same because of this part right here, but if you hold that right in your hand, it looks like they're the same. That's an optical illusion. It looks like they start there and they go through my hand and they come out the other side. The reason it looks that way is because I'm hiding a little piece of information from you right there in my hand. So even though you know they're all the same length, it looks like, you know they're all different lengths, it looks like they're the same length. The first lesson of illusion is you can't believe what you see. The second lesson of illusion is that some illusions are more convincing than others. And here we have rope number one, rope number two, and rope number three. And they all look to be just about the same length. Now, I don't need three ropes for this trick. I don't even need two ropes for this trick. I just need one rope for this trick. So we'll just put them together right there in the center. Now you can tell that the ring is now on the rope. If I tie it on there, it'll be for your safety and mine. There's no way that's going to fly off. I'm going to create the illusion that the ring is off the rope without, of course, untying the knot. Watch carefully. You can see as you pull it right up, still on, off. I know you want to see that again. The camera guys are like, yeah, do it again. So watch carefully. We'll do it so you can see it go on this side of the knot. Watch carefully. One, two, three. Right onto the rope. Yeah, that one's pretty. Now there's no way you can really get it on and off the rope without untying the knot and sliding it off the end. The problem with this rope is that sometimes the ends themselves create the problem by popping right off of the rope. And now I've got two ends over here and one big middle over there, and there's no way to get the ring off the rope with no ends, so we're going to have to put the ends back on right there. We can get the rope off, go right back where we started. When we started, we didn't have one rope, we actually had two ropes. Remember we had two ropes? Actually, we had three ropes. And if you recall at the beginning, they weren't all really the same size. They looked like they were the same size after we did an illusion. But at the very, very beginning of the trick, we had three ropes, small, medium, and large. And that's the meaning of the word illusion. Thank you. Hey, Tanya.
Thank you, Joe. That is amazing. Now, excuse me for walking in front of you just 1 second, but I don't know if the people at home can see, but on your sign it says Magic and Mayhem, which kind of sounds like my house on a Saturday night. But the Magic and Mayhem, what is the mayhem?
Well, the mayhem is the fact that when I'm doing a show, we all interact with the audience. It's not all me up here working by myself. I bring people up out of the audience and interact with them, and we have a good time together. And sometimes it gets pretty rowdy, you know? It's fun, and we're having a good time. I'd like to show you something really fun.
So let me be the together part.
You'll be the together part. All right. You like baseball?
I do.
Well, we're in the part of the year right now where it's starting to get cranked up, and people are excited. I brought a little something. It's a little umpire training.
Okay.
We got a little miniature baseball made out of leather.
Yep.
And a little cup. Make sure there's nothing inside there.
Nothing.
No smoke.
Nope.
Mirrors.
Nope.
Steroids.
I hope not.
Nothing. Very good. Drop the baseball right in there. It doesn't go into a secret compartment or anything. We're going to just put it on the table, and if you think it's under the cup, you'll say strike. If you think I put it in my pocket, you'll say ball. Tanya, was that a ball or a strike?
I just saw you put it in your pocket.
It was a ball. Right. Very good. So you know how to play.
Yeah.
Take the baseball.
Okay.
It's one ball and no strikes. Put it right back in there. We'll give it a one, two, three. Ball or strike. That
okay,
was a little harder.
I didn't see that. I don't know.
What would you guess?
The ball.
Ball is correct.
Yeah,
just trying to help you.
But
you looked away from the strike zone when I did that. You never look away from the strike zone, because as soon as you do, that's when the pitcher is going to sail one right by you.
That's bad. Okay.
We'll do it one more time really quickly. Watch carefully. Right, you can see it in there. One, two, three. Ball or strike? What would you say?
Odds are it's a strike.
I actually know it was a ball. That's good. But I don't want you to be upset, so take a look. There's the strike. We'll put it right back under. We'll put it real slow in there. Ball or strike?
Ball.
Actually, it's neither. That's a wild pitch.
Signed.
It's pre-printed, but you know what? It's Atlanta. It's springtime. It's time for the peaches to bloom. There we go.
Unbelievable.
A little mayhem
for you. That's a little better mayhem than my Saturday night.